Good morning, Sasha Cabarrus.
Today is Tuesday, November 26th, 2019. Please rise
for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Attention STEM students, you are invited to enjoy the light show at Charlotte Motor Speedway. We'll be going on Tuesday, December 17th. Meet at the school at 5:30 to load up the buses. The cost is only $5. See Ms. Nolan to sign up.
The annual CCHS Canned Food Drive is here. Last year, we were able to donate over 1,000 pounds to the Cooperative Christian Ministries. This year, we have hopes of donating over 2,000 pounds of food. We are able to collect sugar-free items, low-sodium items, instant potatoes, toilet paper and bars of soap, canned tomatoes and canned carrots, canned fruit other than pears, spaghetti sauce, and mac and cheese.
Juniors, if you would like a chance to win a copy of the best-selling ACT Prep Guide, follow the student services on social media. A lucky junior will be selected on December 5th.
The PTSO, which stands for the Parent Teacher Student Organization, is hosting a membership drive from November 11th until December 19th. An individual student membership costs $5 and a family membership is $15. Payment can be cash, check, or Venmo. Please take a picture of the screen for more information, and do not forget to fill out the membership form. Student members will receive a pass to wear PJs during exam week, and the highest student club with the highest membership rate will get a donut party. If you are wondering what the benefits of joining the PTSO are, here they are. Members will get to wear PJs during exam week, student spirit weekdays throughout the year, AB Honor Roll celebrations, and treats throughout the year.
Seniors, if you plan to attend the senior trip to Universal's Grad Bash in the spring, you need to turn in your permission slip and deposit ASAP. Deposits are due now. They can be paid online or given to Ms. Small in room 215.
SCCLA will have a club meeting during third period connections on December 4th.
DECA meetings in December will be on the 3rd and the 17th.
November is National Novel Writing Month. The CCHS Writing Club would love you to submit your writing to our online student journal. All types of writing, including poetry, short stories, journalism, and graphic novels, are welcomed. We will be updating the website weekly with new submissions. Just email them to one of these addresses. The link to view the site will be on Miss Biondi's website. Stay tuned for the writing prompt of the week throughout November, and feel free to submit your responses to the site.
CAFE will be holding auditions for their second annual Black History Celebration. We are looking for performers of all types to help celebrate Black History Month. If you are interested in performing in the Black History Month celebration in February, stop by the front office to get an application from Ms. Carter. Applications are due November 26th, and auditions will be held December 3rd in the theater during Connections. Audition pieces should be no more than 2 minutes long. Central's JV basketball will play at East Oran at 4:30.
Central's wrestling team will have a match at East Lincoln at 5.
Central's varsity women's basketball team will play at East Rowan. The game will start at 6.
Finally, Central's men's varsity basketball team will play at East Rowan. The game will start at 7.
Congratulations to our Viking swim team as they defeated J.M. Robinson and A.L. Brown on Friday.
Tennis off-season workouts will begin Thursday, November 21st. Workouts will be on Monday and Thursdays, 2:30 to 4. From now until tryouts in February, on February 12th, to participate, students must have completed the online packet and have a valid physical on file.
Do you know who your representatives are?
frugal, which means you are thrifty. Synonyms include sparing, economical, and careful. In business transactions, Alex was frugal with his money, but when it came to his family, he was generous.
What are you most grateful for and why?
Most grateful for and why?
What are you most grateful
for? What are you most grateful for?
What are you most grateful for?
What are you most grateful for and why?
I would say people in my life, because without them, I don't think I'd be the man that I am today.
I am most grateful for my freedom, because for our entire history, you know, there's people trying to take away, like, your freedoms and stuff, and every single time, there's always someone willing to, you know, nearly die just to make sure that we have our freedom. So I'm grateful for that.
I'm most grateful for my mom, because she's my best friend.
For my mom and my sister, because they support me through everything.
Family and how supportive they are and everything I want to do, including my choices of what I want to major in college after I leave Central, and especially just how they make me feel loved and make sure that I always feel supported.
Family and friends,
I'm most grateful for my dad. He's been there for me through a lot of difficult times in my life, and he continues to support me in all of my dreams and everything that I want to do.
I'm most grateful for my family and friends because they give me so much love and support.
The people that are in my life that keeps me going and push me to do things.
I'm most grateful for the opportunities that I've had in my high school career, including chorus, theater, my whole family and the fine arts, and I love my girlfriend.
I'm most grateful for myself because self-love's matter.
I'm most grateful for the different families that I've joined and the ones that I've had.
I am most grateful for my loving family.
I'm most grateful for everything I have.
Well, I am most grateful for my legs for picking me up whenever I feel down. My arms for always being there by my side, and my fingers, because I can always count on them.